It's early in the 1900s. The center of San Francisco is by the docks on the Barbary Coast. San Francisco's Union Square and downtown area was not as we know it today. But 100 years later, with tourists, hotels, and department stores, Union Square is the undisputed downtown area of the city. Beautiful, rich, posh, and lush, Union Square. We set out to find what was at the heart of it.
So what brings you guys downtown today?
Shopping.
And what are you shopping for?
Anything.
Anything? So you guys are going shopping today?
Yeah.
All right. Probably shopping.
Shopping?
Shopping.
Shopping.
Oh. But I've done loads of shopping.
So what are you downtown today for?
I'm just shopping.
Where'd you go?
Macy's.
Macy's? Do you like shopping in this area?
Yes, very much.
So you're just here to shop, basically. Okay. Cool. Thank you.
What happened to these people? The area is full of them. Coming to the center because it is all they know about, and because they think it's smart, and trying to make something out of nothing.
Shopping's like my workout. I go like every weekend, and
it's
I walk
the atmosphere.
Around.
Obviously, shopping is an essential factor, and right. Usually the main shops are downtown. You know, it's right. Mostly you get drawn back to the city center because there's so much more. People want to see it. There's more history, I suppose.
Why do these people come to the center?
Because. Well, the mall doesn't have a Marc Jacobs store. Oh. And Fillmore, there aren't any Gucci's or Louis Vuitton's or anything.
It's just a cool place to be.
It is the cool place to be. This is where all the business happens.
This is where all the business happens.
It's kind of the center of town, downtown.
This place is so big and busy, you take some time to see that very little is happening. It's just keeping itself going. But this hollow center, this American culture, this capitalist American domain projects its definitions and values onto those far beyond its borders.
Yeah, I mean, everywhere is more Americanized now, and I think especially that Britain, because they just want to copy everything, I think it's just the same as here, and it's more, I think it's a bit more Americanized over there.
I was at the Korean airport because we had a layover, and there were like 4 Louis Vuitton stores, and it looked like I could be at downtown here or like anywhere else.
You see a lot of American corporations and businesses in Stockholm?
Absolutely. It's like little America.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Like, I went to Vietnam this summer, and there are no places to shop there, and so it was kind of boring for me.
I think I like to support local, not only designers, but also just like local stores when it comes to, you know, whether it's groceries or, you know, furniture or even clothing. It's just, it's your community and it's how you make it and it's how you shape it. So, you know, if you don't want a Walmart there, you just choose not to shop there and you support your local, you know, producers of whatever it is you want.
I think that these big brand names, big corporations, the whole concept of logos and driving the market is quite a sinister thing. I've always thought that. Your Nikes and your Gaps and your McDonald's and all those things, really, I think they drive what consumers want and they have far too much power over people. It's kind of scary. I have to sort of try not to think about it too much, really. I think large corporations affect poor countries very badly because you have all your sweatshops and your, people like, you know, have got problems with McDonald's affecting farming and all that kind of stuff. So I think it can only be negative that a few big brands have so much control.
So we went to one of the biggest international American corporations, McDonald's, the staple of American business and culture. As a multinational corporation, McDonald's serves the same American food at every one of its restaurants worldwide. Just as Mahesh brings Big Burger to the bend in the river, McDonald's imposes Western definitions on cultures that are searching for identities. The American people eating at McDonald's have become the role models for the rest of the world. What do the role models themselves have to say about it?
What are your thoughts on McDonald's as an international corporation in the context of spreading Americanism across the world? What's up with McDonald's in an international context?
What is that?
I know
you're using these big words.
It's for English. You gotta be using the big words. Wowzers.
With no answers from McDonald's, we turn to the last place that might hold some clues, the Barbary Coast. But what effects does the center have on its broader surroundings? We went to the coast to see what happened to a place stripped of its identity.
San Francisco was famous by the Barbary Coast. That's all the docks. 1800s, early 1900s, after 1906, downtown disappeared, the earthquake. And everyone started moving along the coastline because that's where all the business was.
As the economy changed from shipping-based to technology-based, the cultural and economic center moved to downtown, leaving the Barbary Coast with an identity crisis.
There is no true identity in San Francisco no more as far as this area is concerned and a lot of other areas in the city. Wherever you got project dwellings, the only identity that you have, if it is identity, is criminal.
The crisis in a bend in the river comes when outside influence drowns out the native people's culture and values, leaving them without means for progress. On a local level, the Chinese in San Francisco were in a similar situation as the Africans, but they chose not to expose themselves to Western ways and are now in a position of power.
Chinatown is so close to downtown, but yet they stay within themselves. Now the Chinese own half of these docks.
So why have people left the Barbary Coast to go downtown?
Where do rich people go? They go where it's glamorous. They don't go where it's gloomy. So why would a rich person who's got trillions of dollars want to come over here to a warehouse and say, this is my paradise?
Who's behind it all?
Money. Capitalist country.
Like, I went to Vietnam this summer, mm-hmm. and there are no places to shop there, and so it's kind of boring for me.
Uh-huh.
As Naipaul says, you can't blame them. They're doing what they see the big people doing.
In liberating strife. Who more than self? Well, country loved. And mercy more than life. America, America, make God thy gold refine.
So you'd rather go to Marc Jacobs and like swim in a pool or
go to the beach?
Are they different activities?
Well, it depends. Yeah.
Well, as a matter of fact, law enforcement has already informed us about tourist attractions. Never touch one, although I am an ex-felon. It is a necessary factor that to stay out of their way is a mandatory count from the law department.
You live downtown?
This is my neighborhood.
Okay, well, do you like buying brand names or are you into smaller local brand?
Small.
Why not brand names?
This is my neighborhood.
Okay, I'm sensing a little repetition here.
What that?
You got three.
I got three?
No, this is all I got.
Oh,
now you have me out with $3.
I'm sorry, man.
Give me a cold beer and a hamburger. I'll be a car through tomorrow. Come on. Hey, cameraman, you have about $1. Come on.
No, I'm the cameraman.